Okay. I will explain you this that problem. Whatever the problem I given as homework. After that, we'll go for the XS3 adder. How we can implement the XS3 adder and 15th and 16th complement and hexadecimal addition and 15th subtraction, hexadecimal subtraction by using the 15th complement and 16th complement. Okay, so here in the last class, I told you XS3 subtraction using 10th complement. XS3 subtraction using 10th complement. So here we take one example. Subtract 235.25 from 111.62. That means you need to subtract a larger number from the smaller number. So that means 111.62 minus 235.25. Okay. So this is subtrahend and this one is multiply, minute. Okay, subtrahend and minute. So first of all, what you need to do? So you need to apply the XS3 code for the subtrahend. Okay, 235.25. So if you apply the XS3 code, okay, so what you are getting? This is 5, 3 plus 3 is 6, 5 plus 3 is 8, 0.2 plus 3 is 5, 5 plus 3 is 8. Okay, so convert into binary. Whatever the XS3 code is there, convert into binary. So what you are getting? So this is 0101, 0110, 100, 0101 and 100. Okay, so this one you are getting. So we have to apply the 9th complement for this one. Okay, why? Because if you are doing a minus b, so this is nothing but a plus minus b. So that means you can write as a plus. So 10th complement, you need to apply the 10th complement of b. So before applying the 10th complement, you need to find out the 9th complement and adding 1 to that, we'll get the 10th complement. So now, first of all, 9th complement of this number. So simply changing from 1s to 0s and 0s to 1s. Okay. So here, if you see, so this is 1010, 1001, 0111.1010, 0111. Okay. And plus 1, we are adding what you are getting. So this is 0, carry 1, 0. Carry 1, 0, carry 1, okay, here 1. Okay, so here you are getting this one again, 1010.0111, 1001, 1010. Okay, and next, so this is the 10th complement of subtrahend. Okay, now you need to find out the XS3 for minute. XS3 for minute, that is 111.62. So what you are getting? So 1 plus 3 is 4, 0.6 plus 3 is 9, 2 plus 3 is 5. Okay, so 0100 0100 0100, 4 is nothing but that 0100, 9 is 1001, and 5 is 0101. Okay, so if you are, you should add this one. Okay, so here anyway, this is 8 and this is 8 and this is 6 plus 3 9, and 2 plus 3 5. Okay, so here you will get this is 1011. Okay, so 8 plus 5 is almost 13. Okay, 13 you added. And 10, so here 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 0 is 1, and 0 plus 0 is 0. And here you are getting carry. Here you are getting carry. Okay, so So that means you are getting some error in this. Carry you are getting means you are getting some error. Okay. Next, so this is 7, this is 4, that is 11. So 11 means 1101. And this is 9 and this is 4, 13, 1101. And this is 10 and this is 4, 14, 1110. Okay. So you got the carry in this, no? So if you got the carry, what you need to do? You need to add to the next bit. Okay. So you need to add to the next bit. So what you are getting? So this is 1101. 0111. Okay. So this is a 0011. And if you are adding 1 to this one, the 1 plus 1 is 0. Again carry 1. 1 1 1. Okay, so this you are getting. And next, so here you should get 7 plus 4 is 11, no? 7 plus 4 is 11. Okay, 7 plus 4 is 11. So 11 means 1011. Okay, so when you are adding this 1 to this one, what you should get? So that means 1 plus 1 is 0. Again carry 1. 1 plus 1 is 0. 1 1 you should get. Okay. And next 1 1 0 1 1 1 1 0. Okay. So now next step, what is the next step? Suppose if you are getting a carry, what you need to do? You have to add the 3 to that number in order to adjust the given number within the excess 3. And if you are not getting a carry, you need to subtract. So in this, you didn't get the carry, you need to subtract 3. Okay, so here you need to subtract 3. So 0011. And here also, here you got the carry, so here you should add 0011. You need to add the 3. And next, here you didn't get the carry, 0011. And here 0011. And you need to subtract 0011. Okay, so this is 13 minus 3 is how much? 10. So that is 1010. You need to subtract, no? Okay, next you need to add 3 plus 3 is how much? 6. So this is 0110. And next 11 minus 3. 11 minus 3 is how much? 9. So that is 1001. And 1101. 13 minus 3. So that is 10. Okay. And next 14 minus 3. 14 minus 3 is 11. 101. Okay. So now you didn't get the carry. What you need to do? The given result is in complement form. Again, you need to apply the 10th complement. So first of all, I am applying the 9th complement. So changing 1s to 0s and 0s to 1s. This is the 0100 0101 and 0110 1001 and 0101. Okay, 01. Okay, adding 1 to this one, adding 1 to this one, you will get the 10th complement. So 1 plus 1 is 0 and carry 1. So 1 1 0 1 0 0 1 0 1 0 0 1 0 1 0 1. And 0100. Okay, so what is this one? This is 4 and this is 5 and this is 6. Point, so in between point is there. I didn't check that point. Okay, so this is 9696. Okay, so you can verify 235.25 minus 111.62. okay, so what you are getting? 5 minus 2 is 3. 12 minus 6 is 6. Point 4 minus 1 is 3. 3 minus 1 is 2 and 1. 123 you are getting. So what is the excess 3 code for this one? So this is 3, 5. 3 plus 3 is 6. Point, this is 4, no? This is 4. 456.96. Okay. So that means you didn't get the carry. So that means complemented form, you need to apply the negative side. So this both are tallied, no? So like this, you need to do the excess 3 subtraction by using the tense complement method. Okay, so next XS3 adder. Okay, so XS3 adder, how we can design the XS3 adder. Okay, XS3 adder. These are the XS3 for B. XS3 for B. Okay. And these are XS3 for A. XS3 for A. So this is a 4-bit adder. 4-bit adder. So here you are getting the carry. So let us consider this is C5. Okay. And so these are the sum S3, S2, S1 and S0. Okay, these are the sums given to this adder, this 4-bit adder. Okay. And now here you have C5 bar. C5 and 1. Okay, so here you will get the sum S4, S3, S2 and S1. So these are the XS3 sum. Okay, so XS3 result, that is sum. XS3 result. Okay, now for adding this one, you need to consider the two cases. So that means here, when you are adding two XS3 numbers, so when you are getting the carry, so that means you can know that you are getting an error. Okay. So for that, what you need to do, you need to add three for that one. Okay. So when you are adding two XS3 numbers, so that is the first case. Second case is when you are adding two XS3 numbers. Suppose you are not getting a carry, what you need to do, you need to subtract 3 from the XS3 code. Okay, so first case is A plus B you are doing. Okay, if C5 equal to 1. Okay, so that means this C5 equal to 1. Okay, so that means there will be an error. There is an error in the given code. Okay, next, what you need to do, you need to add 3. Okay, so that means add in binary form 0011. Okay, so in this case, so C5 bar should be 0 and C5 bar here also 0 and here 1 and here 1. So that means so when you are adding these two XS3 codes, you are getting sum from S0 to S3, and if you are getting a carry, so when C1 equal to 1, so that means you are getting some error. So what you need to do, you need to add with along with these bits. Okay, and second case, if A plus B, when you are doing A plus B, okay, if C5 equal to 0, that means we are not getting any carry. Okay, what you need to do, you need to subtract 3. Okay, subtract 3 means what? You need to subtract 0011. Okay, so that means so as you know that how to subtract, so that means as you know that negative numbers are represented in 2's complement, no? So you need to apply 2's complement for 0011. How you can apply the 2's complement? First you have to apply the 1's complement, that is 1100, and adding 1 to this, you are getting 1101. This is nothing but 2's complement. Okay, so that means so when you are subtracting, that means let us take here you got the sum. So here you got the sum. So if you are not getting a carry, what you need to do? You need to subtract 3. Okay. So this is equal to what? S plus minus 3. Okay. So S plus minus 3, or you can write like this, or S plus 2's complement of 3. 2's complement of 3. Okay. So you got the 2's complement of 3. Okay. So that means, so this is nothing but A plus or S plus. So S plus 2's complement of 3. 2's complement of 3. Okay. So here, what you need to do? In this case, if C5 is 0, okay, C5 is 0. So what you need to do? C5 is 0. So this one is nothing but, so you got the 2's complement, this is nothing but a 1101. So this one you need to make 1, this one you need to make 1. Okay. And so this bit C5, so C5 bar is 1 means what? C5 equal to what? C5 equal to 0. Anyway, this bit will be 1. Okay. So this is the 2's complement of 1. So this will be added with S. So this will be added with S, and you will get the result. Okay. So depending on the two cases, when you are getting the carry, what you need to do? You need to add 3. Okay. So this is the case 1. So this red thing is nothing but the case 1, and this green thing, green colored, is nothing but case 2. Okay. So when you are not getting a carry, what you need to do? You need to subtract 3. So directly we can't subtract. You have to apply the 2's complement. Negative numbers are represented in 2's complement form. So you have to calculate the 2's complement for 3. Okay, so you have to add that with the sum. Okay, so like this you can implement the given adder circuit. Okay, so next we'll see. Fifteenth and sixteenth complement. Okay. So that means how you can find out the 15th complement. First we will see 15th complement. So let us take a hexadecimal number. This is AB 16. Okay. AB 15 to the base 16. Okay. So that means so let us take AB. Let us take this. This is F. Let us take this number as F. This is F. Okay. So AB 1F. Okay. So how you can find out the 15th complement? So each and every bit you need to subtract with 15. Okay. So 15 minus F is how much? We are getting 0. 15 minus 1 is 14. So 14 in hexadecimal is E. And 15 minus B. 15 minus B in say 15 minus 13. So that means 15 minus 11. So that is 4. B is actually 11. Okay. So A is 10. B is 12. 11. Okay. Up to 0 to 9, both decimal and hexadecimal are same. Okay. C is 12. D is 13. E is 14. F is 15. And next 16 means what? 10. Okay, again it will start 1 1 1 2 1 3 up to so on 1 F. Okay, so F minus A, so that means you are getting 5. So this is the value. Okay, similarly let us take one more example, 1 2 5 1 to the base 16. Okay, so 1 2 5 1, so each and every digit you have to subtract with the 15 to find out the 15th complement. 15 minus 1 is how much? E. 15 minus 5, A. 15 minus 2, that is D. 13. 13 you are getting D. 15 minus 1 is, this is nothing but E. Okay. 14. 14 in hexadecimal is how much? 14 in hexadecimal is E. Okay. So like this you have to find out. Suppose for this, if you want to find out the 16th complement, what you need to do? You need to add 1 to this one. What you are getting? This is F, A, D, E. this is nothing but 15th complement. No, I want the 16th complement means for 5 4 e 0, if you add 1, what you are getting? 5 4 e 1. So this is the 16th complement. First you have to apply the 15th complement, add 1 to that, you will get the 16th complement. Okay, next, let us take AB 1 0. You have to apply the 15th as well as 16th complement. AB 1 0. So this is 15 and this is 15. So that means with 15 you have to subtract. So what you are getting? 15 minus 0 is 15. That is F you are getting. And 15 minus 1. So this is E. And this is 15 minus 11. So this is 4. And 15 minus 10. That is 5. And plus 1 if you add. So this is the 15th complement. Plus 1 you add, you will get the 16th complement. F plus 1. So F is 15. Plus 1 is how much? 16. So that means when it is 16, you have to subtract with 16. What you are getting? 0. So that means here 0, 1. 1 is a carry. Okay. Or otherwise, you can convert 16 with hexadecimal. 16 ones are 0. So that means 16 in decimal equal to what? 1 0 in hexadecimal. So 0 and carry over here. So again, E plus 1 is how much? F, 4, 5. Okay, this is the 16th complement. So like this, you have to apply the 15th complement and 16th complement for the hexadecimal number. Okay, next we'll see the hexadecimal addition. So let us take the first one, 4 plus 5. Okay, these two are hexadecimal numbers. Okay, so when you add, what you are getting? 4 plus 5 is how much? 9. Okay, so that means 9 is less than 16 only, no? So that means you will get simply you can do the addition. Same as whatever the addition you are doing in the decimal. Suppose A plus B is there. Okay. So what is A? A is 10 and B is 11. So that means you are getting 21. 21 minus 16. How much? 5. So this is nothing but 5 with a carry 1. 5 with carry 1. Okay. So and next 5 plus 9, you see. Okay, this is actually 14. 14 you will get. Normally if you do the decimal addition, you will get 14, but 14 is having other number in hexadecimal. 14 means 4 into 16 power 0 plus 1 into 16 power 1. So 16 plus 4, so this is the 1 4 in hexadecimal is equal to 20 in the decimal. Okay, so 14 you should not write. As you know that 14 is nothing but E in hexadecimal. Okay, so E is nothing, E is in hexadecimal. So like this you will get. They will take one more or two more examples, like 5F64. This is a 4-bit value, 10-bit value, 2837. Okay, so 4 plus 7 is how much? 11. So 11 is nothing but B. 6 plus 3 is 9. And if you see F is 15 and 8. So this is 23. 23 minus 16. This is nothing but 7 you are getting. Okay, 7 and carry 1. 5 plus 1 is 6. 6 plus 2 is 8. So this is the result. Okay, and one more example. 5F A 3B 2 6 1F. You should add all these hexadecimal numbers. So what is A? A is 10, and anyway 2 directly you can write. And what is F? F is 15. So if you add, what you are getting? 27 you are getting. Okay, so 27 is greater than 16. So when it is greater than 16, what it should do? You have to subtract with the 16. Okay, so when you are subtracting with 16, what you are getting? You are getting 11. So 11 is nothing but what is the 11? 11 is B, and you subtracted, no? So that carry you need to give it to the next bit. Okay, and next one, F is 15, B is 11, again 1. So what you are getting? 7, 8, so 28 you are getting. Okay, 28 is greater than 16. So here you need to subtract with 16, you are getting 12. So 12 is nothing but C, and again carry 1. Okay, again 1, 5, 3, 6. 6 plus 3 is 9, 10 and 15. So 50, what is 15? Yes. So this FCB is the result. Okay, FCB is the result. Okay, so like this you need to do the hexadecimal addition. Okay. So next, 15th complement subtraction. 15th complement subtraction. Okay, so in this, subtraction of smaller number from larger number. Subtraction smaller number from larger number. Subtraction from the smaller number from the larger number. So let us take this example. B502 minus 784M. Okay. These two are hexadecimal numbers. So in this, what is minute? This is minute and this is subtract. Okay. So you need to remember the steps while calculating the 15th complement subtraction. So first, what you need to do, take 15th complement. Take 15th complement or subtract 15th complement from further subtract, and next add it to the minute. Add it to the minute. If carry is generated, what do you need to do? Add it to the result. As I told you in the last class, suppose if it is a odd complement subtraction, either it is a 1th complement, 7th complement, 15th complement, okay? So when you are getting the carry, what you need to do? You need to add to the result. Okay, you need to add to the result. So here you have so B502, this is minute, and 784F, this is subtract. Okay, so first of all, for the subtract, 7478, seven, eight, four, F for the subtract. So you need to apply the 15th complement. So how you can apply the 15th complement? You need to subtract each and every digit with 15. So 15 minus F4. So that means you are getting 0. 15 minus 4 is 11. That is B. And 15 minus 8 is how much? 7. 15 minus 7 is 8. Okay. So this is the 15th complement. After getting the 15th complement, you need to add to the minute. Okay, so my minute is B502. Okay, so this is 2 and this is B, and 7 plus 5 is 12. So 12 in hexadecimal is how much? C. 8 plus B. So 8, what is B? 11. So that means you are getting 19 greater than 16. You need to subtract 16. So what you are getting? 3. Okay, so again you are getting the carry. Okay, you are getting the carry. So here you are getting the carry. So whatever the carry you are getting, So what you should do, you need to add to the result. Okay, so that means this is 3 and this is B, T, and this is 3. Okay, so this is my result. Okay, so this is 15th complement subtraction, subtracting the smaller number from the larger number. Okay, and next 15th complement subtraction, subtracting larger number from the smaller number. 15th complement subtraction. Okay, subtracting larger number from the smaller number. Okay, so let us take these examples. 78 minus 82 to the base 12. Okay, so how you can, so here he given these two numbers, no? How you can identify the given number is bigger or smaller means you have to see for most significant digit. Okay, suppose like 242 decimal you take, 568 is there. Okay, so that means these two values will not, if you compare, so you'll get somewhat clarity. But when you see this most significant digit, this 5 is greater than 2, so that means this number is greater than this number. So like this you have to identify. So see here, B is greater than 7, so that means this is greater than this one. Okay, suppose if you see this one, which is greater, so here 7 is there, most significant digit A is there, so A2 is greater than 78. A2 is greater than 78. Okay, so that means you need to observe which one most significant digit. Okay, so here if you see steps, so steps if you see, take 15th complement, 15th complement for subtrahend. Take 15th complement for subtrahend, and next add it to the minute. Add it to the minute. Okay. Next, if carry is generated, if carry is not generated in this, if carry is not generated, say result is said to be in negative. Result is said to be in negative means what? Means it is in complemented form. As you know that negative numbers are represented in complemented form. Okay, so take the 15th complement, 15th complement of result to get the actual result. So that means when you are adding two numbers, suppose when you are not getting a carry, so that number is in negative, that is in complemented form. So what you need to do, you need to so in order to get the result, you need to apply the 15th complement for given number. So here mind you, is 78 and subtrahend is A2. Okay, so subtrahend is A2, no? You need to apply the 15th complement. That means A2, so this is subtracted with 15. What you are getting, this is 15 minus 2 is 13, so this is D. 15 minus A is 5. 15 minus 10 is 5. Okay, and you have to add with MyNew. 78 is the MyNew. Okay, so when you add, what you are getting, D is 13 plus 8, how much you are getting? 21. So 21 minus 16, so what you are getting? 5. Again carry is 1. Again 5 plus 7 is 12, 12 plus 1 is 13, this is nothing but D5. Okay, so this is the intermediate result, which is negative, which is in complemented form. Okay, so in order to get the actual result, again apply the 15th complement of DA. Okay, again apply the 15th complement of result. So if you apply the 15th complement of result, so that is D5 15, if you have to subtract, 15 minus 15 is how much? A. 15 minus D is 2. Okay, so 2a to the base 16. So this is the actual result. Okay, so that means 78 minus a2 is equal to what? 2a 16. Okay, like this you have to calculate this one. Okay, and next, 16th complement, how you can find out the 16th complement. So till now we had seen the 15th complement, no? 16th complement, 16th complement subtraction. Okay, so first of all, subtraction of smaller from larger. Okay, so let us take D74 minus C52. Okay, so these are the hexadecimal numbers. So this is MyNewt and this is subtract. Okay, so steps, first take 16th complement for subtract, and next add it to MyNewt. If carry is generated, what you need to do for the even complement, you have to discard the carry. Okay, so if carry is generated, okay, discard the carry. Okay, so here my subtrand is C52. Okay, so first of all you apply the 15th complement. Okay, so 15th complement, so what you are getting, so this is a D and this is A and this is 3. Okay, and if you add for this one for this, you'll get 16th complement. Okay, so this is a 3a e, this is 16th complement. Okay, and you have, now you have to add to the MyNewt. Okay, so what is the MyNewt? D74, this is the MyNewt. So e is 14 and 4, so this is 18. 18 is greater than 16, you need to subtract with 16. So that is, here you are getting 2 and the carry is 1. Okay, and next 1 10 7, so here this is 18, again you are getting 18. 18 is greater than 16, yeah? And the next minus 16, if you see, so this is again you are getting 2. Okay, again carry 1. 1 plus 3 plus D is how much? 13. So 13, so that means 17 you are getting. So this is greater than 16. Minus 16, if you see, you will get 1. Okay, so you got the carry over here. Okay, you got the carry over here. So you need to discard the carry. You need to discard the carry. This is the answer. Okay, so this is the 16th complement subtraction, subtracting smaller from larger. Okay, and 16th complement. Subtraction of larger number from smaller number. Subtraction of larger number from smaller number. Okay, so let us take this example. C52 minus D74. Okay, so if you observe this one, C52 and D74. Okay, you need to see these numbers. C is anyway less than D, so C52 is the smaller value compared to D74. Okay, so steps, if you see, what you need to do, first take 10th complement. 10th complement for subtrahend. After that, add it to minute. After that, if carry is not generated, then result is said to be negative, okay, and is in 16th complement form. Okay, in order to get the actual result, what you need to do, again take the 16th complement of result to get the actual result. Okay, so take 16th complement, 16th complement to the result to get actual result. Okay, so we'll take this example first. What is my subtrahend? D74. Okay, so first apply the 15th complement. So what you are getting, 15 minus 4 is 15 minus 4 is 11, that is B. Okay, 15 minus 7 is how much? 8. 15 minus 13, D is 13, 2, you are getting 2. Again, if you are adding 1, you are getting the 16th complement. So this is C, and this is 8, and this is 2. Okay, so this is the 16th complement. Okay, so next you have to add to the minute. So what is my minute? C52 is my minute. Okay, so C plus 2, 12 plus 2 is 14, so that is nothing but E, and 8 plus 5 is 12, that is 13, that is D, and 2 plus C is how much? 12 plus 2 is E. So you are getting this value. So that means, so you are not getting any carry, so that means this is in complement form. Okay, so again you need to apply the 16th complement for this one to get the actual result. So first, in order to get the 16th complement, you need to apply the 15th complement, subtracting each and every digit with 15. So 15 minus E is how much? 1. 15 minus D is 2, and 15 minus E is 1. Adding 1 to this, we are getting 122. So this is nothing but 16th complement. Okay, so this is the actual result. Okay, so like this you need to do the complements for the 15th complement, 16th complement, and hexadecimal addition. Okay, and how we can design the XS3 adder. Okay, so these topics we discussed in this class. Okay.